has many years of significant experience and expertise in the area of quality management system, health safety environment, and commercial testing laboratories. He had worked with public and private sector organizations like APEDA, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, and SGS India Private Limited. He is having lead auditor expertise in multiple quality management systems. His subject matter expertise is utilized by Global Quality Integration Team and Health and Safety Network Team. He attained and maintained a national international accreditation certifications like NABL, National Accreditation Board for Testing and Calibration Laboratories, Client HSC Requirements, Export Inspection Council, etc., for laboratories and business operations. He has been monitoring and supporting the technical and QHSC requirement for the project nominated by Central Institute of Mines and Fuel Research for coal sampling and sample preparation at more than 200 loading and unloading sites of Coal India and power plants. He developed and validated methods of pesticide residue analysis for the agricultural product like rice. He is authorized signatory of NABL for the analysis of basmati rice with well-characterized basmati rice specific molecular markers and analysis of GMOs using real-time PCR. He has done new laboratory setup like designing instrumentation and testing method validation for biological testing and was trainer for short-term and long-term technical training to students and professionals. He has publications in national and international journals on enzyme productions for microbial strains, factor 5 Leiden mutation by real-time PCR and RFLP analysis, RT-PCR and cloning of HN genes and event-specific detection of BT mage using real-time PCR. So now I would like to request Mr. Mishra to start his presentation. It's over to you, sir.
Yeah, a very good afternoon to you all. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir, you are audible. Yeah.
Thank you very much for confirming. Very good afternoon to you all. As I have people from different sectors, so, but I have more concentration on introducing the organization, what we do, and how this quality management system is related with the waste management system. So the basis, when we say quality management system, it means it's something which whenever you implement in whether in your service or in your product, definitely it's going to benefit you. So it's a saying that turnout quality of your service or product that consumers will choose and keep choosing. And if we provide it efficiently and economically, we'll be successful. And that will happen only with the quality management system. If you implement this completely, correctly, then definitely you can make it happen. My slides are having some introduction on the Cotecna services. Then I'll be taking you through what the quality management system is. Then I'll explain you something on the quality, what the quality is, and how this quality management system is related to the waste management. So let me start with what Cotecna does. It's a leading provider of testing, inspection, and certification services. When you say testing means the laboratory testing. It's physical, biological, chemical, all types of testing. So it's commercial testings, what we do. Next is the inspection. So for the trade, the third party inspection is required. Whatever is being exported, imported, sold, purchased. So for that, inspections are being done. And last one is the certification services. Certification services, it is mostly related with the quality management system. So we offer the solutions to facilitate trade and make supply chain safer and more efficient for clients. Global network of professional and certified laboratories providing expertise across 5 key sectors. So these are our 5 key sectors. It is testing, inspection, certification, and two more are the training and technical assistance. So we are the trainers for the different management systems. And supply chain assurance, we assure the quality of the supply chain. We deal with the government and we deal with the private. We deal with the production units, warehouses. So we have multiple type of clients. This is a general overview of the organization, my current organization, Kotecna Inspections. So we have presence in almost 50 plus countries. We are in America, Europe, Middle East, Asia, Africa. And this is just an overview from where we are having how much revenue. We have around 5,000 plus employees. This 5,000 plus is the permanent employee, but contractual, if we consider, it will be more than 30,000. So in India itself, we'll be having around 5,000 plus staff, permanent plus contractual. This is our values. Our vision is true that we strive to be recognized as the most reliable and consumer-focused provider of the testing, inspection, and verification services in our markets. Our mission is we are determined to build a more efficient service delivery platform to better fulfill our customer needs in a continuously changing marketing environment. We act with passion, we make it happen, we care about people, and we communicate openly. And we are accountable for whatever we are doing. So these are our values. We have complete transparency what we do, and we expect the same from the people who are connected with us. So these are the main four business line: agriculture, metal and minerals, certification and training, verification of conforming. Services and network organizations are testing, inspection, certification with a focused effort in expanding our analytical capabilities, certification, and digital services. A more densified network with some activities run vertically and other in a matrix. This is how we are in India. This is our India network. We have an head office in Mumbai, but our headquarters is in Geneva. So we are a Geneva-based company. In India, it's in Mumbai. We have branch offices in New Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Indore, Kandla, Vizag, and Odisha. We have operational unit at Haldia, Paradip, Krishnapatnam, Kakinada, Andal, and Singrauli, Nagpur. So these are multiple operational locations. We have laboratories, testing, commercial testing laboratories all over India, which are accredited by National Accreditation Board for Testing and Calibration Laboratories. So that's the regulatory body which regulates the testing in India, that is under Quality Council of India. So we have laboratories in Vizag, Indore, Kandla, Delhi, Kolkata, Babil, Chennai, Paradip, Mumbai, Haldia, Bangalore. So across complete India we are covering. And we operate in almost all the ports of India. These are some accreditations what we are having for India, that is 9001. 17020, 9001 is for your quality management system. 17020 is for your inspection. 17025 is for laboratories, and 17065 is for product certification. So these all are quality management system requirement. But if you say 9001, it's purely quality management system applicable to any type of business, any type of service you are having. It's irrespective of the business and type of activity what you do. It's applicable to academic, it's applicable to productions, it's supply, whatever activity you are doing. It's even it could be applied to a small shop. So that could be applied anywhere. These are the memberships what we are having: Federal of Oil, Seeds and Fat Association, mm-hmm. that's FOSFA, GAFTA, Feed and Trade Association, International Federation of Inspection Agencies, it's IFIA, International Sustainability and Carbon Certification, International Fertilizer Association, Sugar Association of London and Refined Sugar Association, RSA, International Cotton Association, Federation of Cocoa Commerce. So these are some membership which we have listed down here, but there are a few more. So let's start with the commercial services. What we do in commercial services, it's testing, inspection, and certification. In this, we verify, monitor, audit, weigh, count, sample, test, and certify agriculture, minerals, and metals, and general cargo products along with their respective supply chain, helping industries produce, handle, transfer, and bring their products to market, comply with international and local regulation and requirements, mitigate risk, and be more sustainable. So when we say we certify the industries like agriculture, minerals, metals, so agriculture, almost all the agri commodities, minerals and metals, coal, iron ore, steel, fertilizers, so all those comes under minerals. And general cargo is whatever cargo, it could be machinery, any cargo which is under trade. That is covered under, we have a business called verification of conformities. That's the agreement between the governments where they nominate certain bodies in different countries from where who are authorized to verify the quality, which will be accepted by that government of that country. Next is trade and finance support, providing risk mitigating tool. We help commodity trade finance sectors and borrow at different stage of the transaction, that is production, storage, processing, transits, etc. We also help in providing the risk mitigations, how to mitigate it, and we also help them to trade the finance, trade finance in their business. Next is inspection services. Our inspection team help client verify contractual conformity for a comprehensive range of commodities and good with speed and accuracies. So many of you may not be aware what the actually inspection means, because testing, commercial testing, as you people, everybody knows what the commercial testing is, because we are going through the COVID-19. So we are going for RT-PCR testing. We are going for other testing methods. Those are done by the commercial laboratories. We are the similar type of laboratory who does the commercial testings. So that is called the testings. But when we say inspections, in our type of inspections, we inspect the products which are under trade. So for the purchaser, for the buyer, for the seller, they need an independent, there will be a buyer, there will be a seller. So the buyer and seller, they need an independent third party test the quality to inspect the product and provide some results, outcome on the basis of which the trade happens. So that third person, that independent inspection is done by us. So that's what we call inspection. In the inspection, it involves visiting the sites, taking samples, sending it to the laboratory, testing, test reports, and physical parameters, all those things, even the quantity, all those things are carried under inspections. Services are loading and discharge supervision. So whenever a product is loaded, discharge, vessel hatch and hold inspection, water tightness, supervision of weighing, tally control, draft survey, tank gauging, contractual sampling, sample preparation and sealing, testing and analysis, traceability, identity preservation, trade finance support. These are different things which comes under inspection services. Agriculture and food product inspections and testing. In this, it's personalized verification and monitoring, weighing, sampling, testing, and certification services across the entire agriculture supply chain. Inland services are crop and harvest monitoring, on-site grading, weighing and testing, traceability programs, silos and warehouse in and outtake, stock monitoring, quality maps. Port services are weighing, tallying, measuring, sampling, and lab analysis, inspection of sealing of holds, tank, containers, wagon, trucks, draft survey. So these are, I'm not taking much time of explaining different terms in this. It's just to get you an overview, because there will be certain terms which you may not be aware. But if anybody having further any interest, they may contact me further to explain what this is. Then comes the laboratory services. It's international network of state-of-the-art laboratory providing exemplary product testing to ensure quality standards are met and all local and national rules and regulations are adhered to. Over 400 accredited laboratories strategically located across key trading area. It means our laboratories are located in such locations that we cover entire India, for India, and even we are covering the most crucial locations of the world. Comprehensive range of testing services for commodities and a multitude of consumer products, including physical, chemical, microbiological, and contaminant testings. Services are physical and chemical testing of samples against required contractual, international, and regional standards, quality certificates based on results for independent and accredited laboratories. When we say independent and accredited laboratories, we mean the laboratories should not be part of any other business. They should be independent, they should be standalone, and should be accredited by the national bodies. In India, it's NABL who accredits the laboratory. Even EIC, APIDA, they also have their accreditation, but 17025 is globally accepted. So when I say 17025, that's the quality management standard for laboratories, specifically for laboratories. Agriculture and food, you can see it's input, production, logistic, industry, trade, food safety. So what we do, inspected and tested products are grains, oil seeds, byproducts, meals, veg oils, soft commodities like sugar, cotton, etc., pulses, and some food products also. Industries, we cover agro industry, farming industry, food and feed processors, traders, transporters, financial institutors, insurers, and government organizations. So these are the different industries which we cover. For minerals and metals, different stages, like at the stage of mining, storage, logistic, industry, trade, are present at all the stages. Inspected and tested products are what products we handle are coal, ores, different type of ores, concentrates, nickel, steel, and other ferrous and non-ferrous metals, scrap and secondary products, fertilizers, and other minerals. The industries what we cover are mining, mineral processing, traders, smelters, refineries, end users, fertilizer companies, and the insurers. For general cargo, it's components and raw materials, materials in process, finished products, supplies in cargo, trade. So these are the general cargo. So we cover almost everything in general cargo. As we said, we have a business called verification of conformity where we do this. So the products what we test are consumer goods, manufactured products, special purpose machineries. Industries what we cover is clothing, cosmetics, toys, electronics, machinery, and other related. When we say government trade and solution, it's this, like though public and strong private partnership, we provide turnkey customized solutions that allow customs and fiscal administration to fight against fraud, prevent capital fights, protect revenues, enhance national security, facilitate legitimate trade, move towards more digital control processes. We offer bespoke services and ensure the transfer of core competence routinely providing capacity building programs. So these are the different services what we have. One is classification and valuation, that we call it as a value quest. These are mostly all our software-based innovation platform offering technology-based service designed to boost customs revenues through the setup of a national valuation database. Next is cargo scanning services. We are pioneers in non-intrusive inspection services for custom and security authorities, ensuring trade facilitation and border security. GSM device monitoring, we have a MobiClear, a real-time monitoring solution that help authorities combat mobile device fraud and enhance national security while raising tax revenues. Automated risk management, CRMS, that is field-proven risk management solution designed to strengthen customer administration capabilities in order to fight illicit trade. Transit monitoring solution, CoTrack, that's turnkey solution specifically designed for customs to enhance their capability to monitor goods in transit, combat fraud whilst facilitating trade. And last is inspection management platform, that is CoView, innovation solution that connects non-intrusive inspection technologies for controlling event in the field in real time, thereby improving custom operational excellence. For this, we have recently started property tax solution, that's ITLES, that's integrated end-to-end solution designed to assist local governments in managing the entire value chain of property tax system. So this is something recently which we have started. And last is verification of conformity. We ascertain that mandatory quality and safety requirements set forth by government or imported goods are met prior to exportation. That is, it's valid for countries where Cotecna has been authorized as a verification body. As I said initially, that we are being authorized by that government so that we can do this business, we can approve the product, we can do the inspections. So some list of some countries are, like, we are doing it for Algeria, Egypt, Ethiopia, Iran, Kenya, Libya, Nigeria, Saudi, Sudan. So these are some countries. Yeah, and next we come to our another business, CQR. The most relevant business related to the quality management system. So this, for this, I'll be taking a little more time. Under CQR business, it's the certification and training services. In this, the services what we offer is the certification, that is accredited services based on international standard, your commitment and compliance. You can see some logos. So we are authorized by NABCB as an independent certification body. So we can do certification for 9001, 22001, IFS, GMP, HACCP, and there are a few more, even for the IMS, GMP. We'll come to that. So for all those things, we have been certified by regulatory bodies for doing the certification as an independent body. And next is training, virtual instructor-led or face-to-face training. So we have done virtual trainings, we do virtual trainings, and we conduct face-to-face trainings also. We do audit, that is audit services on various standards, including national and international regulatory requirements, evaluate or compliance. So if any case, any organization wants to go for any of the standards, we do the audit, we do the gap assessments, and help them to make their system so that they can go ahead for the application for the standard they require to apply for. Under certification services, these are the different sectors what we cover. For food safety, what we are authorized is for Codex-based GMP, FSAC, HACCP, ISO 22000, IFS standards. So all these are related to food, all these are food safety standards. So for these different standards, we are authorized for the certification. And for the management system standards, it's ISO 9001, that is quality management system. 45001 is your health and safety management system. ISO 14001 is environmental management system. ISO 31000 is, it's related to integrated management system. When we say feed safety, we are doing it for GMP plus FSA, that is for food safety. Cosmetics, it's ISO 22716. For forestry, if FSC, COC, that's certificate of conformity. Sustainability, for sustainability, we are accredited for ISCC, EU and plus. For sector specific, like for tea, we are having accreditation from trustee. For seafoods, we are accredited for GAA, BAP, ASC Farms, ASC, MSC, USC. So that's for certification of conformity. So these are different standards against which we are accredited to do the certifications. Training services, so under these are different topics under which we provide training services. In food, you can see it's same HACCP, BRC, ISO 22, FSCC, IFSS food. Management system training, it's 9000, 14, 37, 8000, 45000. Food safety or other topics, understanding food safety culture, zoning concept of environment monitoring programs, understanding food fraud and food defense, allergen management in food industry, FosTech. We do all the courses of FASTech regulatory updates from FSSAI, ECQI for human foods. General, it's updating procedure post. So these are some general things what we have started after COVID-19. We have developed operating procedures. So what you should do to start your work after COVID-19. We do overview on hazard identification and risk assessment, HERA, emergency response and disaster management plans, implementation 5S for a safe and healthy workplace, training on various labor laws in India. For laboratory management system trainings, we do it for ISO 17025, that is internal auditor training and implementation. Gap assessment, we do for food safety standards, food safety and related standard. International regulatory compliance, we do it for US FDA, FSMA requirements and other country specific regulation. Customized assessment or customer requirements, second party checklist based. Then we also do the supplier evaluation. We do FSSAI audits. It's like the companies who are into food production, for them it's mandatory to have these audits. So we do FSSAI audits, that's for Food Safety Standard Authority of India. Then we do hygiene rating, Eat Right Campus, street food vendor audits. So these are different activities what we do. In general, we have developed WASH and CASH. WASH is developed during this COVID, that workplace assessment for safety and hazards. So we do the assessment of your workplace, whether it's an institution, academics, production, service industry, whatever it is. So we do the assessment of your workplace, how you operate, what we do, and to help you with a safe workplace, to help you to provide a safe workplace. We also do the fire safety audits, SHE audits, social compliance, and other similar audits. These are the special services offering, disinfection and sanitization service. This we have started post-COVID, that we use ULB foggers, use of EPA-approved globally benchmarked disinfectants to remove or destroy pathogens. Disinfection services delivery in compliance with federal, state, and local laws. Service delivery based on WHO and CDC guidelines, timely and effective operation to maintain premises free from virus and bacteria. Operation team using all work-related protective gears, which are medically cleared to use and fit tested to wear. Service execution by trained and skilled personnel. So all these are done by our trained and skilled personnel. Value proposition, experienced and competent team of auditors. We have best-in-class certificate. Our TAT turnaround time is very low. Our speed of service is very good. And we are one of the global energy brands with worldwide network. We are continuously adding to our scope in the certification, training, and audit products. We are known for timely issuance of internationally recognized certificates, e-training certificates, technical help decks, and hand-holding for customer queries. And we are very competitive in the costings in the market. So we deliver products with the quality. These are some unique services offerings, that is public seminars, webinars, and awareness sessions we organize, continuously adding latest certification, training, and audit products as per the market needs. Management commitment towards customer feedback and query within 48 hours. So that's the unique offering what we have. These are different credentials what we have for certification business. We are accredited by NABCB. That is National Accreditation Body for Certification Bodies, IFS, FSPCA, FSAI, FASTech, FSSC, Trustee, T-Board of India, GMP Plus, APIDA, ISCC. So we have recognitions from all these bodies. Now, let me come to the quality management system and how this quality management system is associated with the environment management system and waste management and how it can help. So I'll take you a few slides with to understand what the quality management system is and why it is required. Why quality management system? When we say quality management system, the word itself says quality in the management system. So this quality management system ensures increased revenues and higher productivity for the organization. So when you say increased revenue, here increased revenue does not only mean you are getting something directly, some financial benefits, or you are increasing your product selling, you are increasing your sales services. See, it's a saying that each penny saved is each penny earned. So this helps you to save a lot and to sustain in longer term. So when I say increased revenue, it also helps you to control your expenses. There are many things, many expenses which we don't see, but which becomes in the process. It may be like damages, returns, means the products which are returned, bad names. So if you have a bad name in the markets, that's very difficult to regain it. If you have lost the name in the market, lost the reputation, that's very, very difficult to gain it. So this also helps you to maintain your reputation. You cannot see how much you are losing, but actually you are losing. And it also helps in the productivity for the organization. Whatever you do, it doesn't matter. You are running an institution, you are running an academic institution, you are running a service industry like ours, you are having a production plant, you are doing agriculture, farming, anything. You are having a chain of pizza, more Domino's food chain, if you have anything, whatever you are having. So it definitely helps you to increase your productivity and increase your revenues. It removes unnecessary processes which merely waste employees' time and do not contribute much to the organization's productivity. So ultimately, whatever activity we say, it is related with the manpower, the people, and the machines. So these two things controls the business, controls the operations. So if you can reduce wastage of your time, wastage of your employees' time, you can definitely increase the productivity, and revenue and outcome will definitely, you will be benefited with that. Quality management enables employees to deliver more work in less time. So when you have a good management system in place, definitely we all will agree with this. I'm sure we all will agree that if there is a good management system, if there is a quality in your management system, the outcome, there will be definite increase in the productivity. Quality management helps organizations to reduce waste and inventory. It enables employees to work closely with associated people and incorporate just-in-time philosophy. Quality management ensures close coordination between employees of an organization. It inculcates a strong feeling of teamwork in the employees. So when you have those things in your system, when we all work for a similar goal, see what quality management system does, it's whether it's you are managing the waste, whether you are taking care, you are doing your, seeing your process, considering the environment, all that feeling should be in your entire group of staff. If the top management sitting in their chambers and decide, no, we'll do something good for the environment, we'll minimize the waste in our organization, that's very difficult to do. But when each and every staff in your organization have that feeling, no, we have to reduce the waste, we have to have our process in a way that least environment is affected, we can maintain the flora and fauna. So when that feeling is from top to the bottom line, then definitely the results will come. So that's what the quality management system does. It keeps the employees connected. Everybody works for the similar goal. Even the lowest cadre employee knows what the company vision is, what they are looking for, what they want to do, or what is important for them, how much careful they are for the environment, how much they take care of the waste, what we generate. So all those things should be there. So what is quality? In different terms, when we say transcendent definition, it's excellence, that you look something beyond the expectation. Some people say that that's the best quality, if you have an excellent service or product. If say product base, it's quantities of product attributes. When it's user based, like if you ask an end user what the quality is for them, it's the fitness of intended use, meeting or exceeding user expectations. Means for whatever purpose I'm taking that service or product, it should be fit into it. Meeting or exceeding our expectation, whatever I expect from that service, from that product, that should be met. Like if I talk about any product, whatever you are handling, you expect, take an example of a soap. You expect that soap should have a good smell. It should not be harsh to our skin. So that's the some expectations. And it should clean also. So its intended use is to clean, but the expectation are it should have good smell. It should not melt very fast. So these are some expectations. It should be of good qualities. It should not have some bad impact. So these are for the products and for the services. Like if you have a teacher, maybe a class teacher. So a class teacher should be capable. You expect that class teacher should have enough knowledge to teach you. That is the intended use. They should have the knowledge what they are teaching. But what the expectation from the students are, that whatever they are teaching, that should be understood by the students who are listening to them. So whatever service or whatever products you are having, that should meet the intended use and the expectations of the users, of the end users. Value-based definition, it's the quality versus prices. Definitely, we check whatever we are getting. We compare that with the price, whether it's the product or services. If we target to give the best quality in minimum price, so that's very debatable. Like for few people, price is more important. Then other things come secondary. For few, price and other qualities, they compare equally. So that for quality, if you say quality, for you, quality may be different. For me, quality, defining a quality may be different. I define a quality with whatever product I'm getting, that it should fit the intended use, this would fit my expectations. It should be of considerable price. It should not be very costly. For some higher class people, they consider, okay, this, if the product is having a bit of cost and is very good presentable, they consider, okay, this product is better than this. So for them, seeing the quality is different. For a middle class, seeing a quality is different. And for a lower class, a low income group, the quality would be different. Manufacturing-based definition is conformance to specifications, that whatever specifications are defined for that product, for that services, that if I say product and services, means product, there are some specification that this would be the design, this should be its running capacity, this should be its intended use, so that should comply to that. For if you say services, we have committed, we will be doing this, we'll provide this. So that those are the specification which we have given. Like as I said, our TAT time is 48 hours, we issue EDOC certificate, those are the services. So we have to comply with those specification what we have mentioned for our services. What the quality is, meeting the stated requirements of the customer now and in future. So quality doesn't mean it's only one time you have met. If whatever you are running, whatever business you are doing, whatever organization you are running, the quality should be developed in a way that you can maintain that quality. The quality should sustain for a longer period of time. So therefore, there is a term in the quality management called continual improvement. You need to see the improvement options what you have. You may have to change the technology, systems, people, with changing environment. As the degree to which a system component or process meets specified requirement and customer or user needs or expectations. So the system components and processes, they meet the specified requirements. Specified requirements by means whatever requirements are listed, that it should be like this. So those requirements should be met. Customer and user needs and expectations are met. So whoever are the end users, whoever are using that service or product, their needs and expectations should be met. Needs or expectations. See, when we say needs or expectation, needs are like, I need a shirt. So, okay, my need is to have a shirt, but my expectation is that shirt should be of good quality, that should be properly stitched. Those are my expectations. My need is to only have a shirt. So whatever needs and expectations of the customer is, that should be fulfilled. So that we call a quality. Okay, I need a shirt, I got a shirt. So its fitting should be good, its color should be good. So those are the expectations what I am having. A totality of features and characteristics of a product or service that bears on its ability to satisfy stated or implied needs. So it should satisfy whatever the stated and implied needs are. That should be in total. Degree to which a set of inherent characteristics fulfill the requirements. Whatever a set of inherent characteristics are mentioned, that should be fulfilled. When you say inherent characteristics, it means, suppose whatever product or services you have, let me give an example of a product for this. As I said for previously, that's for a shirt. For a shirt, you expect that, okay, shirt should be stitched properly, should be of proper culture, it should be of proper color, its color should not fade off. So these are the different characteristics of that product. So whatever that should fulfill against the requirement. These are different dimensions of the quality for the performance. That is, will the product or service do the intended job? We see, when we say the quality, these are different dimensions what we use to measure the quality of a product or services. So first comes the performance. We check whether the product or services is doing the intended job, for what purpose we are taking that service, for what purpose we are using that product, whether it is doing the job. If you had a maybe hair trimmer, so you'll see its performance, okay, whether it's doing the activity, it's trimming the hairs properly. So that's for a product. And if you say a service, like for us, we provide the inspection services. People expect, okay, we have to give the timely services, there should be a quality in the services, reporting should be on time. Those are the performance. When you even you evaluate in the academics also, you evaluate your professors, your teachers, your HODs, they are evaluated somewhere, no matter at what position you are, but your performance has been evaluated. So we all provide service, similar type of services. So their performance has been measured. Reliability is how often does the product service fails. Means whatever service or product we are providing, how often it fails. Means whether it is reliable. There are, okay, if you give lectures, you are giving lectures from maybe 10 years. So I hardly seen bad lectures from anybody. So failure is almost negligence. So another professor who is like, who fails to give proper lecture, maybe every month there'll be one or two lectures for which he may not be performing well. So that's the service. Sometimes the failure for that one professor is more in one case, and the further for another, it's hardly like considerable. So it's almost negligible. The same goes for the products. Like whatever products you consider, a mobile phone, there are some brands who have very long term, their battery life is good, they do not hang after long term usage. So that's more reliable. If you compare a brand like Apple and a brand, normal brands are coming, maybe normal brands, Chinese brands or similar brands, which are lower in cost, but they are not more reliable. Durability, how long does the product service last? So whatever product or service you are having, as I just now have given you an example of Apple and another lower brands mobile phones. So you can see the battery life, the quality of the Apple mobile phone is quite long. It lasts for sometimes, I have an experience of using it for 5 to 7 years. but I have used another brands of that too, also maybe equally with equal cost, but they are not that much durable. Serviceability, how easy to correct the product services to solve the problems in service. So whether it's a service or a product, when you find a gap, a mistake, an error in between your service or in the products, how you solve them, how you are handling it. That serviceability is to be checked. Aesthetics, what does the product service look, smell, sound, feel like? So how the actually it is. If I say we are having services, okay, the people get good feeling. Okay, the service looks like they'll be giving good service. Your products, okay, by seeing it looks like, okay, fine, this products may be good. So when we say we start evaluating a product or services from like its branding, from its communications, from the products itself, so those are things are also important. Features, what does the product or do service gives? What the actually what features that products are having? Perceived quality, what is the reputation of the company or its product services? So what is the reputation of that organization of its products and services? We have a multiple brands of car in the market. We have many teaching institutions. So what, how we see the quality of education, I'll give you an example of, let's take it for the institutions only. If you, there are thousands, maybe lakhs of institutes in India. But people see the reputation. Okay, this institute is having good name. Their students are well placed. They are having good faculty. They are well known in the market. So that is the quality. What there's a reputation what that brand is having. So that's also helps to considering the quality. Conformance of standards. Is the product service made exactly as the designer standard intended? So if something is to be produced as per the standard, as per the requirement, as per the protocol, so that should meet that requirement. So these are different dimensions which are used for evaluating the quality. So quality of difference, quality in different sectors are for airlines. I have taken some examples how the quality is seen in different sectors. Airlines, it's on time. Should be on time, comfortable, it should be low cost also for healthcare. Diagnosis should be good. Minimum wait time should be there. Cost should be low. Security should be there. You should have a security that you are not getting any contamination over there when you go for analysis, for the testing. Food services, good products, fast delivery, good environment. Hygiene is maintained, postal services, fast delivery, correct delivery, cost containment should be there. Academia, there should be proper preparation of future, on-time knowledge delivery. So when we say proper preparation of future means you are preparing the students, your staff is prepared as per the future requirements. So they should, because when a student takes an admission in first year, they'll go out after, maybe if they are into BTech degree, they'll go out in to the market after 4 years. So what will be the expectation after 4 years or after 10 years? So the education should be prepared like that. On-time knowledge delivery. So knowledge should be given on time. If I need that knowledge in today's environment, today's world, so that should be given to me today. That should not come like, that should come, that's planned after 2-3 years when that technology may be outdated. Next is consumer products, properly made, defect-free, and it should be cost-effective. Insurance, for insurance, payoff should be on time, reasonable cost should be there. Military, rapid deployment, decreased wages, there should be no graft. Automotives, there should be defect-free. The automotive should not have much of the defects. Communication, clearer, faster, cheaper solutions should be there. So in almost all the cost, all the sectors, costing will be definitely one of the factors to consider the quality. Now we come to quality management system. A quality management ensures superior quality products and services. That is, a quality of a product or services can be measured in terms of performance, reliability, and durability. Quality is a crucial parameter which differentiates an organization from its competitors. So whatever organization you are doing, whether you are a waste management organization, where you are an academician, where you are an inspection agency, where you are a product-based company, it helps you to be in upper hand with your competitors. A quality management system is essential for improving your operations and enabling it to meet the requirements of customers or beneficiaries. Once your organization is certified implementing total quality management, it enables you to evaluate all processes to improve efficiency and reduce the waste generated in your process. Some people think, okay, no, we are not the product-based company. We are providing the services. We are educational institute. We are the inspection bodies like us. We don't have any product. So we don't generate any. It's only the factories and production plant who generate the waste. But that's not correct. We also generate a lot of waste. That should be, we have water waste. We have waste like papers. We have, maybe we use air conditioners. We use generators. There are effluents in our premises. We travel. So there are so many things. When you analyze what are the different type of waste you generate, that maybe when you will sit and take pen and paper and start analyzing, you will find there are a lot many waste. Am I audible? There was some disturbance in between.
Yes, sir. Yes, audible.
Okay, thank you. So this helps to improve the efficiency and reduce the waste generated in your process. A quality management system is to direct and control our organization with regard to its quality. When you say quality management, it's quality planning, quality assurance, and quality control. So quality planning will be, you will be planning what you have to do, what are your targets, what is your vision. So that will be based on the criteria. Quality assurance, that will be based on prevention driven. Quality control is inspection driven. And it's the quality planning. It identifies the standard and determines how to satisfy those standards. It lays out the roles and responsibilities, resources, procedures, and processes to be utilized for quality control and quality assurance. Quality assurance, it is a review to ensure aligning with the quality standards, and assessment will be provided here. Planned and systematic quality objectives provide the confidence that the standards will be met. In quality control, it addresses the assessment conducted during quality assurance for corrective actions, measures specific results to determine that they match the standards, use of statistical process control, a methodology for monitoring a process to identify special causes of variation and signals the need to take corrective action when appropriate. SPC relies on the control chart. When we say SPC, it's statistical process control chart. So we have a control chart you may be using in your laboratories, in your labs also, your system also, where you have the upper limit, lower limit, and you check the variations. Accordingly, you check if something is going beyond the limits. When we say quality control, quality assurance, and quality planning. See, quality control is normally, in simple words, quality control is whenever you have a checks in between, to check whatever service or whatever products you are giving, it is of the same quality. When you say assurance, that involves that there should not be any mistakes in this, any errors, the any gaps in the products or services which we are going to provide. So quality assures that there should not be anything, any gaps, any errors, and quality control identifies the gaps and errors and rectify it and correct it as early as possible. And quality plan, we need to have a planning to do all this. So that's why it is said quality is said to be a preventive action, and quality control is said to be we inspect inspections. So these are some internal and external benefits of quality. Internal benefits, it reduces the costs, increase reliability and maintainability,
increases the speed of your process, your service, boost morale of the people, increase customer retention. Whoever your customer, end users, your beneficiaries are, it increases their retention. It also increases the profit. So when you have more beneficiaries, when you have more clients, definitely your profit will increase. External benefits are customer get correct product or service. So end users are getting the correct product and services, correct specifications, appropriate intangibles, customer satisfaction should be there, customer retention will be there. There are some drawbacks also, that is long way to establish in the organization. So you need to put a lot of efforts to establish this in an organization, but once it is established, it will, because it's not going to give the results next day. Today you have established and for tomorrow you will start getting results. It takes time to get its results. Quality management design not allows fit to purpose, lot of cost effectiveness if not understood and implemented correctly. So it may not always fit for the purpose if that's not understood and implemented correctly in an organization. Substantial efforts are required. You need to have a good team. You need to have the people who understand it, who implement it, who monitors it. So you need to have put a lot of effort from top to bottom to maintain it in your organization. Maintain system, otherwise reject it. So if you cannot maintain the system, there is no point saying that we are having it, because that's definitely going to help you when it is going to be maintained in an organization. Environmental management system, that is a management system for environment, ISO 14001. When we say quality management system, it was ISO 9001. When we say environmental management system, it's ISO 14001. That is aligned to quality management system, but this is specifically for the environmental management system. The part of the overall management system that includes organizational structure, planning activities, responsibilities, practices, procedures, processes, and resources for developing, implementing, achieving, and reviewing the environmental policies. An environment management system brings together the people, policies, plans, review mechanism, and procedures used to manage environment issues at a facility or in an organization. So this management system helps you to get together your people, what policies you have for the environment, what plans you have for the environment, what is your review mechanism, what procedures you follow. When we say environment, it's related to how we reduce the waste generation, how we recycle the waste. All those things comes under the environment. Our process should be designed in a way that pollutants should be low. So this involves facilitating, this facilitates environmental compliances. So we have to, when you apply this environment management systems, it will facilitate you that you are comply to the environmental compliances, address environmental impact. It will also help you to address what the environmental impact will be from your services and your products. It also broadens environmental responsibilities to all those who work can have a significant on the environment. So this broadens, like you will also understand who are responsible. You can identify people, you can authorize people. So that will also have a significant impact on the environment when people will know their responsibilities. Environment office has technical expertise to contribute, conduct periodic monitoring of environmental performance, identify root causes of findings and conduct corrective and preventive actions, maintain environmental records. These all things will be required. Environmental aspects in QMS. The environmental aspects refers to all the ways in which your company interacts with your surrounding environment. When we say environment aspects, so it refers whatever activities our organization is doing. So how our activities are interacting with the surrounding environment, that should be considered under this environment management system. An important step in the process of aspects identification is determining the severity of each aspect This will help define which are significant enough to be included in your system. You are not required to address every aspect that you discover, only those that will make a significant impact or are highly regarded as important by your stakeholders. So this will help you to define what are the different factors which can influence you. So once you address, you may consider some, you may not consider some, but at least it will help you to identify what are the different aspects, what are different environmental aspects are. After you have identified the significant environmental aspects your system will address, you will work to create the criteria and controls need to minimize their impact on the environment. This is perhaps the most direct impact of your environment management system. The minimization of your organization's, that's company's process and outputs on the environment. So this will help you to minimize your company's process and outputs on the environment. Quality approaches have traditionally maintained a fairly strict focus on business and customer issues such as reducing defect and waste and improving efficiency, profitability, and customer satisfaction. So businesses and businesses were fairly more concentrating on reducing the defect and reducing the waste in their systems. Environmental and sustainability goals for quality initiatives are relatively recent because the business world is accustomed to treating environment practices as source of added cost. The challenges for quality practitioner is to identify where environment and sustainability quality issues such as reduction of waste and use of renewable energy also serve business and customer interest. So this is one of the important factors why I have taken you all through all those understanding on the QMS, why it is required, what the quality management system is, because these goals still it's not very much considered by the business professionals. They consider this as an additional cost. They are accustomed to treating environmental practices as a source of, they consider this as another cost. So that is the challenge for the quality practitioners. But and then there are some costs which are direct cost, but there are some hidden costs which are not visible. But once it is implemented, they come to know that it's how much it's helpful for their organization. Environment sustainability. When you say environment sustainability, it is defined as the responsible interaction with the environment to avoid depletion or degradation of natural resources and allow for long-term environment quality. So when we say environmental sustainability, we mean we have to take steps to avoid depletion and degradation of natural resources, minimize their usage, and allow that it should be available for long term and the quality of the environment is maintained. This is how the environmental aspect slowly evolved. That is, it started initially with compliance management and till now it's at the stage of sustainability. In around till 1994, the compliance management was only meant focusing by the regulations and relying on environment department to react the issues. By 1998, environment management system brought a more systematic organization-wide focus on environment issues. Then by 2002, environment information management system involved, which was using web-based system and integrating multiple system. Then by 2006, environmental process management make use of quality tools using a project focus to drive the environment. And after 2006 to current, sustainability requires integrating environmental, social, economic goals and using best practices to address risk and uncertainties. So it took a long time after, before like 2002, you can see there was not much concentration on this. Now we have a good system, good management system, which is there for the environment management system. Key steps in waste management system are You prepare the written procedure, work plans, instructions, you prepare the reports. The function and responsibilities of which waste management groups are defined. So you have, once you apply this management system, you need to have the procedure, plans, instructions, reports. So all those things will be recorded. You can maintain it. Your process will be system based. It will not be person based. So that could be maintained. You have the responsible people who will take that responsibly. The strategic directions of the organization and assurance that waste activities are planned, organized, managed, developed, implemented, and it's budgeted. So budgeted is also very, very important. We should also take budget for the activities, what we do for the environment. The activities are compliant with state law regulations while assuring minimal disruption. Program excellence is assured through contract performance measures and self-assessment of the programs. Okay, so now it's waste management and quality management system. So how this quality management system helps in the waste management system, how it is integrated with the waste management. And so this we'll be discussing in further slides. When we say waste management, what we understand with the waste management, it's like whatever waste, it could be any type of, it could be air, water, any, it could be like sound, whatever waste pollution, whatever it's coming out, which can pollute the environment. So that should be managed in a proper way. And if you have a good quality management system, definitely we can manage it. And sometimes once you understand the waste, you can create something good from that waste. Even in some countries like Singapore, you may see they have developed a big parks, gardens. There are some people who from the waste, they have started developing roads. So they are using the waste. We have been managing the waste properly. Now we have under this waste segregation thing, Clean India, we are segregating the waste. So that is the way we are managing the waste. So once we have a quality management system in your waste management, so that the segregation of waste in the different bins like solid waste, liquid waste, food waste, that's the quality management system that comes under quality management system. So once we manage the waste properly, definitely we can recycle it, reuse it, reduce it. So recycle, reuse, reduce, that could be done when we have a quality management system in it. So with the example, it's the hazardous waste handling facility operations are planned, directed, and managed. So for the waste management, whatever hazardous waste we are generating, it's how to handle it, how the operations should be there, how it should be planned, there should be the direction, there should be proper management of that waste. The processing of universal hazardous radioactive mixed waste at the hazardous waste handling facility, including waste collection, transportation, storage, labeling, sampling, treatment, consolidation, inventory, compacting, packaging, shipment, and assures compliance of the national and state regulations. See, whenever there is a waste generator in any system, you have the laboratory, you may be having the laboratories. Even in the academics, in the laboratory, we generate a lot of waste. That waste, sometimes they are very hazardous. Some chemicals, hazardous, toxic chemicals, carcinogens. So to dispose that waste is our responsibility to segregate it, to dispose it properly. You need to have a disposal procedure system in your organization for the disposal of waste what you are generating. So that discovers everything. You need to have a specific place where you can collect the waste, how you will be transporting this waste, that should not be stilled, where you are storing that. You may not be taking out the waste daily, you may be storing. So their proper segregation, proper location should be there. The waste should be labeled, there should be proper sampling treatment. If some treatment is required, there should be consolidation. Inventory should be maintained that these waste generated, this has been disposed, this has been neutralized, compaction should be there, the waste should be properly packed, and it is to be exported somewhere for sent somewhere for the disposal, the shipment should be there. If there are any compliances requirement for some of the waste, like in our industry, we have some petroleum products which come as a sample for us. So there are some high regulatory requirements that after certain quantity, we cannot store it. So it may explode. So that location should be away from the residential area. So those are certain regulatory requirements. If we have to transport, we have to transport by this vehicle, this much quantity only. So whenever you are handling any waste, there are regulations which we need to follow. We cannot throw the waste anywhere in the environment. That comes under our responsibility. And if not followed, so that may come on us in future also. Maybe regulators may come back. And we may have even legal action if that products are not being disposed and they are hazardous to the health. See, anything which is directly impacting the health of the people is considered strictly by the government. All matters of waste characterization and transportation compliances ensures waste generated in process are described sufficiently to support compliant management on site and to meet the waste acceptance criteria of off-site treatment storage disposal facilities. So if you some may be disposed on-site, some chemicals you have a process to neutralize it, then dispose it at your end. Some you may have to send at some disposal plant. Their proper disposal facility should be there. So those criteria should be acceptable. A highest quality work is ensured, and for identification for management, potential problems where quality may be affected. So a highest quality work should be ensured. So there should be a proper identification, management, and potential problems should be where quality may be affected, should be understood. When we say waste characterization, by waste characterization, we means finding out how much paper, glass, food waste, etc. is discarded in your waste stream. Waste characterization information helps in planning how to reduce waste, set up recycling programs, and conserve money and resources. So when we say all matters of waste characterization and transportation compliances, you can see that under waste characterization, all the services, all the industries, you can do the waste characterization of your organization. Even in the houses, we have the paper waste, we have the glass waste, we have the food waste. We are also having it at our workplace. That should be characterized, segregated, and discarded in a proper way. It helps to conserve the money and resources. Waste management, that is in this quality improvement should be there. Random sampling, when you say quality improvement, random sampling done for incoming generators waste to verify generator waste characterization. So you do the sampling sometimes, what type of waste effluents are coming out. So what are the different types of waste you are generating? Major waste characterization of regulatory failures required issuance of non-conformity and corrective action reports. Upon verification of implementation of corrective actions and the generation of required records, the NCRs are closed. So when you do the waste characterizations, when you find there are some regulatory failures, you issue non-conformities that these product, this waste, or this segregation storage, this thing is not complying to the requirements by the regulatory bodies or our internal requirements, so that the action is taken, the root cause is done, and then further some preventive actions or corrective actions are taken before closing that non-conformity which is identified. Then we do the trend analysis. In the trend analysis, it should include, but not limited to, non-conformity reports, assessment findings, and root cause analysis. The ultimate purpose of this trend analysis is to proactively attempt to move trends that require a management response before the trend becomes an actual problem. So why we do the trend analysis? Because when we do the trend analysis of whatever any system, you come to know that, okay, these are the some gaps identified. So we should identify that gap. We should some may require some efforts from the management also. So there should be a response. So before it becomes a problem, we should take some proactive actions. So that is why we do the trend analysis. Segregation and non-conforming items. When the non-conformity condition involves a physical item, it's a physical item, or if it is in your service, when you find that some non-conformance is identified, maybe if I say for an inspection, an inspector is going for an inspection at the port, but we identify the inspector is not going on time. They always, after loading is completed, then that inspector goes to the port. Then then that is the conditions that they are not complying to the requirement. And when I say for the waste disposal, they have a cycle that this waste should be, like you have a waste segregation and a vehicle always come after bi-weekly to collect the waste. So you have a system in your organization, from each department the waste is to be collected at this place, and then from here it will be further given for disposal. And that waste could only be stored for 15 days. And maybe you missed to collect waste from one of the departments. So if you have a proper documentation, proper management system to collect and dispose, to track that, to track their life, storage life, all those things, so that could be controlled. The item is segregated when practical by placing it in a clearly identified and designated hold area until it is properly handled. Performance and lessons learned for future activities, areas of improvement may result in procedural and instructional changes. Performs root cause analysis and develop lessons learned to prevent problems from recurring. Such activities is commensurate with the hazard, significance and consequences of the problem. So for inspection and testing, in accordance with the applicable local, state and national regulations, the effluent must be inspected on daily, weekly and monthly basis depending on the item inspected. Record of these inspections are maintained and any deficiencies noted are corrected and documented in a timely manner. So whatever waste we are generating, we should, if it is like if you find they are the hazardous waste, there should be proper sampling. If you have a setup like generators in your commercial setup, even in the institutions, there are requirements from the pollution boards that you should do the sampling. The report should be there. Whatever waste you are throwing out from the laboratory, there should be a record. The water coming out, there should be testing. So all those things should be there. The proper monitoring testing should be done. There should also be a self-assessment. The adequacy and effectiveness of the quality assurance program must be determined by conducting management assessment on an ongoing or periodic basis. So there should be a continuous assessment. It should not be only one-time assessment. So we should do self-assessment, continuous assessment, and we should always take steps to continually improve the management system. So the motive with this is we have to do the things right first time. It always costs less to prevent a problem than to correct it. Correction always takes a lot of time, a lot of money, but prevention is definitely, mostly in most of the cases, cost less. So these are different at different social media. We have LinkedIn. We are at the Kotekna group, we are Twitter, Facebook. Connect with us at anywhere. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Dharmil.
If participants have any question or any query, they can ask directly or put your question in the chat.
Any participant want to interact with us, sir? And there
is one question from Manishita Mukherjee. Manishita, you can ask now.
Thank you so much, Rashmi ma'am. Good afternoon, sir. I would like to ask you, sir, suppose if an industry is accredited with ISO 14000, then such measures which you have just spoken about, that is mandatory for them and they have to follow it. But sir, say for example, there is another industry which is not ISO accredited, and as you just said, that prevention is obviously better than cure. But in India, unless and until legally enforced, do the industries really bother about following the various environmental management or the quality assurance things? Are they really bothered until unless they have got a legal foundation for the same?
Yes, see, earlier they were not bounded, but now they have to, because the consumers are very much educated now. Now we are the consumers. We understand what products we are going. We understand the quality. So if you have two options, you find one organization which is accredited by 14001, which is accredited by 9001. They publish it. They tell you that we are certified for this. We manage the quality. We care for the environment. And both have the equal cost. Definitely, you will go for the organization which is following that management system. You will have more trust on them. They'll have more business. So to compete in this environment, they will be. They don't want to, but they have to, if they have to compete. Definitely,
no, because I fully understand. But sir, there are some other things. Say, for example, I have gone to purchase a mixer grinder. And obviously, as a common person, I would be looking into maybe the 5-star ratings, which are also not always very much true. So, sir, my concern is regarding the waste management, the waste which is getting emitted out, like, say, for example, the hazardous waste might be which is getting out from the industries. Right. You also know that, how do I present? I'm not able to present my question in a proper manner, sir.
I very much understand, see, what you mean to say, that you an organization is maybe having 14,001, but sometimes they do not follow. And we all know, we all live in India, yes. We know how much people actually, how much they take it seriously, how we are handling our waste. Even in the general life, you see people throwing on the roads. We don't care about polluting the environment. So we live in an organization which is therefore making a profit. We as a people, there are very few people who actually cares about the environment. But now that group, maybe earlier it was 0.5%, today it may be 5%. So that group is increasing. Now we care for the environment. We have seen the virus. We are seeing the pollution in New Delhi. We are seeing, if we won't care, it will be difficult for us to breathe. So we also have to live in this environment.
True, sir. True. Thank you.
Yes, very true, sir. Dharmendra, I would like to specially thank to you that you have presented a very 360-degree approach to the waste management system, that every technology needs this proper system. Until or unless the system is not in place, no technology is going to help us in days to come. And these are the type of tools which are very, very required and are the utmost demand of the time. And now I would like to invite Dr. Rashmi ma'am to present vote of thanks to Dharmendra Mishra.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Your presentation was very enlightening and very vast. So, sir, for today, it was a very great session. So now we will, Vikas, sir, we will meet tomorrow for the next year. Yes, sir.
Hope everybody was awake because it was
a session. Varied domain experiences have been shared on this platform, and there are so many other sessions has also been going on, and yes, with different aspects. So I'm fully confident that everyone is enjoying the sessions covering every aspect of the waste management system. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation.
Any questions? Please, Dr. Rashmi, please, Dr. Vikas, please share it with me.
Yes.
I'll be happy to answer it.
Yeah, of course.
Sure.
will be sharing it with you, and I'll be providing a contact to Mr. Sir to all the participants so that they can interact with him afterward this session as well. I guess there is one comment into the chat box. Yeah, thank you. So we'll meet tomorrow on the same program schedule, as per the program schedule. So thank you all for attending and joining us. Thanks all.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Thanks.